Good morning all of you. This is the very first video for the subject Grid and Cloud Computing, and this belongs to the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in JNTUEA. And this is the introduction to first unit, and in this unit we are going to see the introduction to the distributed computing, grid computing and cloud computing. This is the textbook prescribed by the university, Distributed and Cloud Computing from Parallel Processing to the Internet of Things. And hereafter we are going to follow only this particular textbook for our syllabus. Unit 1, Introduction. In this unit we are going to study the following topics. The first one is Evaluation of Distributed Computing, Scalable Computing over the Internet, Technologies for Network-Based System, Clusters for Cooperative Computers. And these are the topics will come under Evaluation of Distributed Computing. After that, we are going to study the Grid Computing Infrastructure, Cloud Computing Infrastructure, Service-Oriented Architecture, Introduction to Grid Architecture and Standards, Elements of Grid, Overview of Grid Architecture. So these are the topics we are going to study under the Unit 1. First, we will see what is Distributed Computing. A distributed computing architecture consists of a number of client machines which will be connected together with a very lightweight software agent is installed with one or more dedicated distributed computing and management servers. That is, a client machines will be connected together to form a distributed computing, and a lightweight software agent, that is a software program that will be installed on the servers to control the client machines. That is, to control, manage and maintain the client machines, we are using the software agents. And the agent that will run on the client machines usually detect when the machine is idle. What's the purpose of software agent? That is used to detect when the machine is idle, and immediately that will send notification to the management server that the machine is not in use and available for further processing job. If the machine is idle, then immediately we can assign a job to that particular machine. The agent then requests an application package for that client machine. When the client machine receives this application package from the management server to process, it runs the application software when it has free CPU cycles. If it has free CPU cycles, then only it can perform the process and sends the results back to the management server. When the user returns and requires the resources again, the management server returns the resources was using to perform different task in the user's absence. That is, if the machine is idle, then immediately the server will use this particular machine to perform a different resources or different task. The next one is distributed program. A computer program, the distributed program is also a computer program that runs within the distributed system is called a distributed program. There are many different types of implementations for message passing mechanism, because all the computers which are connected in the distributed network are communicated through message passing only. So there are many different implementations there for message passing between the computer systems, which includes pure HTTP. HTTP means Hypertext Transport Protocol, and RPC. RPC means Remote Procedure Call, like connectors and message queues. So by using these techniques, the systems will be communicated through each other by using the message passing mechanisms. Distributed computing also refers to the use of distributed systems to solve computational problems. What's the purpose of distributed systems? Distributed systems are used to solve computational problems. In distributed computing, a problem is divided into many tasks, each of which is solved by one or more computers, which communicate with each other via message passing. Next, we will see the definition of grid computing. Grid computing also combines computers from multiple administrative domains to reach common goal to solve single task. Here, the size of grid may be very small to very large network. For example, public collaborations across many companies and networks. Grids are a form of distributed computing, whereby a super virtual computer is composed of many networked, loosely coupled computers acting together to perform very large tasks. This technology has been applied to solve scientific, mathematical, and academic problems, and it also used in commercial enterprise applications. The next we will see cloud computing. Here the basic architecture of cloud computing and grid computing are almost the same, but the purpose is different. Here also so many devices will be connected to the service provider, that is centralized server, and the purpose is the cloud computing enables user to access cloud resources. So here the users are going to access the cloud resources from anywhere. Anywhere means anywhere in the globe at any time. Anytime means 24/7 through their connected devices from service provider. So service provider are going to provide the resources to their clients anywhere at any time. Cloud computing is a resource delivery and usage model to get resources. The resources are nothing but it may be either hardware, that is CPU, memory or network, or any software or any applications. Everything are called as resources via network. Network here is the internet by on demand. On demand means if a user requires, then they can demand the resource. And at scale, means how much resource they can adapt, then they can demand that particular resources as a service. Service here means there are three different services there. First one is free service, next one is subscribed service, third one is paid service. Okay, so the cloud computing is a resource delivery and usage model to get resources via network by on demand at scale as a service. Distributed system models and enabling technologies. Distributed system models are the parallel computing systems or distributed computing systems which are uses multiple computers to solve large scale problems over the internet. So what's the purpose of distributed system models? To solve large scale problems over the internet. Here the distributed computing becomes data intensive and network centric. Large scale internet applications have significantly enhanced the quality of life and information service in the society. In the first unit, we are going to study the evolutionary changes that have occurred in parallel, distributed and cloud computing over the past 30 years, driven by applications with variable workloads and large data sets. And here we are going to see the evolutionary changes of the processors, network, memory and the storage devices. All those things will be combined together to form the parallel network or distributed network. And we will study both high performance computing and high throughput computing systems in parallel computers across appearing as computer clusters, service oriented architectures, computational grids, peer-to-peer network, internet clouds and Internet of Things. These systems are distinguished by their hardware architecture, operating system platforms, processing algorithms, communication protocols and service models applied. And the essential issues on scalability, performance, availability, security and energy efficiency in the distributed systems, scalable computing, distributed systems and virtualization, parallel programming, security and peer-to-peer networks. All these things we are going to see in the first unit. And thank you all of you for watching this video. And in the further video, we are going to see all the topics in detail.